Global inflation has become a key theme in the markets as price pressures pick up. To what extent are developed economies worrying too much about inflation accelerating based on the Bank of Japan's experience?
I think the discussion regarding a possible surge in inflation is particularly relevant to the United States. Some academic economists have pointed out to such a risk, mainly considering the large-scale economic measures and progress with vaccinations. In fact, international commodity prices have risen recently, and the U.S. Inflation rate has accelerated. As a result, markets have been somewhat unstable at times. Now, the Fed, I understand, pointed to the following two factors in this regard. First, the recent acceleration in the inflation rate is due to the base effect and the temporary restriction in the supply chain amid the rapid recovery in demand that reflect the reopening, so to speak, of the economy. Second, labor market slack is still significant. Given these factors, the Fed emphasized that it would maintain an accommodative stance of monetary policy so that inflation averages 2% over time, and long-term inflation expectations are well anchored at around 2%. I think this policy stance is based on the recognition that it will take time to overcome low inflation once it is entrenched. As you know, this is also a lesson learned from Japan's experience of prolonged deflation. That said, of course, it is true that central banks around the world have been conducted monetary policy while facing significant uncertainties due to the shock of COVID-19. In this situation, I think the appropriate conduct of monetary policy and effective communication are important in terms of ensuring market stability. So the Bank of Japan will continue to closely monitor developments in global financial markets and the global economy. And now, turning to the outlook for prices in Japan, the inflation rate is likely to increase gradually, but it is expected to take time to achieve the price stability target of 2%. So the Bank of Japan will continue to persistently conduct powerful monetary easing in order to achieve that target, that is to say 2% price stability target.
So does this mean that we will have to wait longer in countries like Japan and other countries for change in policy?
Oh yes, of course. I mean, each central bank has to adapt its monetary policy to its own economy, price, and financial situations, and so that even if our economy recovers from the impact of COVID-19 pandemic, we expect by the end of this year the economic activity level would come back to the level prevailed before the pandemic. But as you know, our inflation rate continues to be relatively low, and it will take time to achieve this 2% inflation or price stability target. So that I must say that in that sense, Bank of Japan's substantial monetary easing will continue even after the economic recovery from the pandemic is achieved, because we have, like other central banks, 2% inflation or price stability target, but our inflation rate is still quite low and so we have to be persistent in conducting our monetary easing to achieve 2% price stability target.